if I say it, Bernie, stand on it. I speak my soul through my music, I'm so passionate. And if you think about taking my chain, just know you would die with it. When the f***ers count your pockets, you gotta watch that. Ain't have a pot to you did. You say this brother fell off, it did. I'm the brains and you the muscle, that's Bernie still. And really speak they mind off them perky pills. They left me hanging and left me abandoned, that hurt me still.
We fell off and it was a shootout.
I think they murk me still. In the studio smoking anxiety, coming up with new bars. I try to stop it, I try to stop it, that too far. Been around my brother to give me endurance, I ride with two blocks. And I'm thinking about getting insurance, trying to do me like Tupac. Ooh, it hurt my soul. They disrespect me on the net, don't pay no attention. They told me don't die young because I'm talented.
You been here today to celebrate the sponsorship of KICKASSO Customs. So big shout out to KO KICKASSO from my Los Angeles, California. He always seems to look out for the boys in a good manner way. So we're gonna start this by an episode. You know? Y'all can get me Ward on the phone and Miguel on the phone. You know, so Haji, Swazo, Nafis, Charlie, Mentally Ward, Miguel Lopez, Ryan Thompson. You know, those that's episode one. They put it on their back. And everybody mad at them. And everybody telling them what little black kids can't do. And they showed everybody they could do it. Until this day, where a lot of y'all wondering why y'all could walk in school and they calling you Nightcrawler and yelling OTT at your game and just met you this year. Thank them, man. That's real talk. This is what society don't teach us in the environments we come from. So they tell us, with me and you, bruh, you know, you, bruh, they stop at us. They don't go past us. We don't pass it to him, but we don't pass it to them to pass it to them. It stopped at us, and that's why our environments don't grow. So when you wonder about Unk trying to put his foot down your throat, and I'm trying to choke the life out you every chance I get, because it don't stop with you, man. It don't. I put you in the house with them, bro. Just from them being in the house with you, whether you ain't got to say a word to them. But they're going to learn how you walk. They're going to learn how you use the bathroom. They're going to learn how you open and close the refrigerator door. They're going to learn your mannerism. They're going to learn how you sleep. Everything about you, they're going to pick up. Because that's how life works. Whether the brain works when you know the brain works when you sleep, right? You know, you could be playing something in the background while you sleep and wondering why you memorized it the next day. Because the brain never slept. Remember, while you sleep, how you think you breathing? How you think your heart going? How you think your nerves and everything else is moving? It's your brain. Without it, the body is dead. So it's the only thing in your body that makes everything work. You got me? So we're gonna start this off. We're gonna go first on the list. You know what I'm saying? They call him Real Uzi. He real slithery. You know what I'm saying? Real slithery. I'm gonna get that to that boy Bang. I'm gonna get to that boy Venom, man. Oh. Venom can get you clean.
Ready, one, two, three?
Nice.
I got your camera.
Try to chase me. Shoot that web, boy. You leave right there where you lay at. Mr. Spider-Man. You know what I'm saying? National known. You feel me? Stretching his arms out all over the place on top. Mr. Tall Tower himself. AKA Charles Wall. AKA Mr. Elastic Man. AKA Mr. Fantastic. Run a 4.3 speed. I'm wrong about that? Huh? Watched him go to the Nike Combine. They made him run a 40-yard dash 4 times because they couldn't believe how fast he was. Watch politics try to hide him every single year because they just want to deny his talent. You know what I'm saying? It's on the iPad, bro. You feel me? So we gonna let his little brother, you know, he think he mini on the low. He think he mini on the low. You know what I'm saying? But it's crazy how you see all the kids now where they really watching them. Like, you got kids running up to them. Yo, that's the Flash. You get what I'm saying? They really they neighborhood superheroes. And it's dope, man. So, you know, hanging here, we're gonna have the Express Mail, these joint Express Mail delivery. So on behalf of OTT.
You know?
Being that big brother that he really is, man. You know what I'm saying? We call him Mr. Hide in the Dark. Mr. Blow Your Lights Out. You know what I'm saying? Mr. H, a.k.a. Hodge Loco. A.k.a. Hodge Cannon. A.k.a. Mr. Black Panther. You know what I mean? Different, man. And he took him, he fought me every day.
I'm a strong safety. I'm this, I'm that. Nah, you, you. Like, learn, you, you, look in the mirror. Like, you see what you see? You, you, bruh. And he fought me all the time. And then, I don't know, something clicked. I forgot what it was. I think it was 7-on-7 or something. And we were just popping him around everywhere. And he just kind of came to me like, yo, like, I could play this. Like, I ain't know I could do this too. Then we start touching him, you know, in offense and so forth. And, you know, in school where he changed the structure of the school he came to live with me in. He come to me in the house like, yo, like, chemistry, dope. You know what I mean? It's a kid that, you know, he pretty much say he ain't gonna play football. That's all you gotta do. Forget school. So to see him progressing in grades, to see him, like, grabbing so many different angles where he normally wouldn't get it, you know? And he got this tenacity, man, with him that just, like, he unbreakable. You know what I mean? Like, every time you think you got him down, it's like he just heal himself. Right? You know what I'm saying? It's like he just, you know what I mean? Like you hit him and it's just like it ain't even faze him. He just recuperate and he back at your door. Like he gonna hit you first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter, game over. He still trying to kill you. He ain't gonna stop. You know, so he earned his name to be, you know, that indestructible Wolverine. You know, he's not here right now. He's not here to collect these. So we express melodies to him. You know, his brother Hodge Local, aka Black Panther, could collect them on his behalf. You know what I mean? But we'll have these things down Maryland real soon for you, young man. So we got one more who's not here right now. He's in Arizona, so he's on a different time. Everybody here know what PTSD is? Yeah.
No.
It's what a lot of veterans who was in a war had. And when this kid came to me, you would feel he had PTSD. Because we always say athletes got two deaths. They got the death of when whatever they worked for is finally over, and they got to deal with the reality of everyday life outside of the sport world, and when they actually die. And this kid, man, like, he just went through a lot of changes as a kid, where normally the average kid would have been gave up. You know what I mean? And to see him go through the challenge and go through the challenge and go, you know, it's like when you see that light, you know, hit that melanin, you see that gold spark come out, you know, with that glow from the light when it hit our skin. You know what I mean? And he got his name pretty much, you know, we call him Super Suave, aka Superman. You know what I'm saying? He out in Arizona right now in school. That boy just threw for 4 touchdowns the other day. Oh, my bad. These wrong ones. I'm sorry. That's many joints. This Superman, Cleat, aka Super Swash, we're express melodies out to you immediately out of Arizona. Here we at school right now. He shot me, man. He showed me with dedication, like what we really doing at OTT. Like he showed me vividly, you know, how the outcome is. Like how you can progress from it. You know what I mean? Not just in sports, just as an individual overall, man. You know, and this kid been like, he's been on the DM every year. Yo, I wanna train with OTT. Yo, I wanna train with OTT. Yo, I can be a part of OTT. And I'm talking about every, I'm like, yo, man, you gotta get your parents involved, bro. Like, you gotta get the parents talking, bro. I talk to the kids, I love the kids, but we gotta get these parents on the line somehow. And he, you know, he got older and he finally, you know, he always was there. You know what I mean? And he finally, you know, he got his way through the door. You know what I'm saying? We call him like, he like a quiet assassin, man. Real humble, laid back, super grown. You know what I'm saying? And then just slide, shoot something to you and blow you right on up. You know what I'm saying? My boy Jordan, man. AKA Gambit. You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God.
AKA Ace of the Old. You know what I'm saying? Now this kid right here, man, you know how many fights I be getting over this kid? Boy, I tell you, they too be trying to call him, everybody else is there calling his name. He remind me of this person. He remind me of that person. He remind me of that person. I would always drill him since he was in seventh grade. Like, you, boy. I don't care who you look like. You. Oh, he the next Jabril. No, he ain't. He the next Christian Abraham. It's that simple. Like, he him. And stop telling the kid who else he gonna be. You can pick up traits from everybody in the world. It's called a mastermind. But you yourself at the end of the day. Like, don't deny him from being himself. And they fought because, you know, people want to ride his coattail. And they want, you know, he's so talented. He got offers from colleges early on, you know, eighth grade, ninth grade, you know. And, you know, it's hard. I tell him all the time, it's hard when you hear, man, it's a certain work ethic. Like, talent gonna take you, with talent gonna take you. But ain't nothing like trained talent, man. Everything you see outside and around you, the brain made. Somebody sat there and thought about it, and their brain came up with it. And you see light bulbs, the fixture, this banner, this table, chairs, forks, knives, cups, glasses, you name it. The brain came up with that. Everything you see every day, the brain came up with. And that comes from them training their talent. That's how it works. That's how the brain works. Whether it's physical, mental, whatever you want to name it. Trained talent ain't nothing like it, man. And I would be on him, and he would. I remember one day we finally was right next door. And he cried. I'm talking about boo hoo crying. Like I want my mommy crying. And he kept looking at me, and he crying, thinking I'm about to be like, oh no, it's okay. And all I said to him was, swallow it. And the cries turned into, the tears kept coming, but then it turned into from a frown to a, and then that deep breath turned into a grit, like a, and then the tears stopped, and you just seen these eyes that was red, and he, and then you see the chest raising up, and he just, let you know, oh, Mini, Charlie, and all, they just looking at him. Get it! And he just, he was born. And if anybody know anything about X-Men, he the one that be in the wood, he be in the woods, and he alone, and he, but he special. He the only one that get Wolverine to run for his money. That's my boy, Big Dog. AKA number 5, AKA Saber 2. It's my junior, man. It's my nephew, man. I love you, boy. I would prefer Nike, but I know you're the school sponsor. So, I got, I ain't taking nothing over nothing, but I gotta go with this, man. this kid right here, man, you know, he where everybody was doing, right? He ain't fast enough, he ain't quick enough, too tight in the hips, slow, this, that. But outside of everything you ever said, I seen him shut every motherfucker who ever stepped across his path up. Faithfully, consistently, smart as an ox. And he shows you IQ gonna override talent any day. And he trains his behind off with everything. Humble as all hell, ain't gonna hear peep out of him. And when you do hear peep out of him, he's smacking the life out of you and letting you know. You got on offense, right?
Yeah.
Get out the game. Because I'm playing for the rest of the game. And he shows it all the time, man. You know what I'm saying? My boy, man. Always fighting with Batman. My boy Bane, man. Boy King, man. I know what that DNA say every day. You know what I'm saying? And he got something in him that we're going to make sure it come out through football. We're going to make sure it come out through football. You know what I'm saying? Because he's something else, man. And he don't even know it at times. He ain't even tapping to his full potential nowhere near yet. Because he keep restricting and hiding from it. He want to do what he want to do. I love him to death, man. And he always got his helmet on because, you know, I'm going to bust him upside his head. It's my nephew, man. My A Spoon Coon. Kumar, a.k.a. Juggernaut. You to put them gloves on in a heartbeat. Like, what? put the gloves on. You get there right now. You know what I'm saying? So I always tell people, man, like, he's small, but you will see him, you blink your eyes, and he'll be gone because he got a stride that's out of this world. And I mean, when I first got a hold of him, he fought me the whole entire summer because he wanted to drag his foot. And he wanted to do what he wanted to do. And he fought me, and he fought me, and he fought me till one day, what are we doing this drill for? And I broke down every single last step, foot placement, route, redirecting to him. And he couldn't say nothing. Oh, well, you do this in this part of the field, right? But ain't that what that for? Or you do this when it's close contact, ain't that what that for? You do this when somebody playing you like this to Shane or quarterback for the year, for the ball doing this, ain't that what that's for? And he just got quiet. And I think that was the day when he bought in. Now you see him, now you don't. AKA Safi Fett, Safi Fett, AKA Philly Feet, AKA Nightcrawler. He got Under Armour because the school is sponsored by Under Armour.
I know what school I'm at, by the way. BCW.
So this kid right here, man. This kid right here, he came around when the first episode came around. So he kind of had it like a little different than a lot, like a lot of this episode four got. He had it rough from the rip. He's been around since he's been 7 years old, 8 years old, faithfully. And he never once, you know, I look up, it'd be May. You blink, it's August. He ain't go home yet. You know? But his mannerism, his respect, his just overall everything about the kid, man, he's special, man. Like he dedicated to himself outside of. And anything he do, he dedicated to himself. And that's hard to have, you know, especially at his age, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, this is my young bull, man. Mr. Quiet Assassin himself. Mr. Big Nose. Kenyon Massey. Yeah. AKA Dad Bull.
Yeah, bro, boy.
You know what I'm saying? So now this kid right here, he's a mama's boy, stone cold mama's boy. You know what I'm saying? And he fight me all the time. He love me to death, though. And I remember we were somewhere, and the coach said, man, do he ever speak? I said, yeah. He said, when? Put the pads on him. And other than that, he ain't gonna say nothing. Put him on that field, he turns to something else. You know? And he don't say nothing. And when he do say it, it's just like a couple of words. I'm gonna get you. You know what I'm saying? So we call him Hide the Shadows. You know what I'm saying? We call him Mr. Quiet Storm.
Yeah, my boy.
AKA Fly By Night. My boy Isaiah, AKA Batman. As y'all know, this is Bane's little brother. And Batman and Bane is always fighting. Y'all gotta see their fights, they unreal.
Alright, ready? One, two, three. You get me? Come on, man. I got you though.
Now this kid right here, man. This boy, man. Little meatball head joker, man. Nah, he come from blessed by the walk of life you got, boy. For real. Cause he another one that got something in his veins. That's, you know, everybody got what they got in their veins, but you just gotta know the walk of life that people come from. And they try every day to make sure you ain't gotta walk that life, man. For real. It's about sacrificing. You know? And he always, you know, he talented. But he always would come to me and he would think he gonna just kind of bulldoze, you know, he always bulldog and everything. He gonna work his way. I got this. And then he'll be looking at me crying. He'll be looking at me mad, sweating like a slave. He wanna go home and start, I'll call my mom, I'll go home. You know what I'm saying? But I told him when he was younger, man, like you gotta, we gonna make sure you built like iron, bro. Put your suit on, you gonna be built like iron. My boy Meatball, aka Yasin Willis.
Young boy, aka Night Train,
aka Iron Man. That's my boy, man. So we got this kid right here, man. You know what I'm saying? It's my house boy. He fought me and he argued with me and he fight me and he used to call to get picked up and then, you know, Mom Deuce is backed up. Like, what? I remember one day he called for something and she was like, wait, man, get the fuck off my phone. And I was like, ooh, you in trouble. So when I seen that right there, I said, he locked in. It's over. I got green light to do whatever I want to do with you. And he bought in. He bought in, man. And he still got a long journey. He young, like I said, man, he only in eighth grade right now, but he bought in. And he grinding daily and faithfully and over and over, man. You know what I'm saying? This might get my house boy. You know what I'm saying? AKA Macacatino, oh. AKA Kino. You know what I'm saying? AKA Daredevil. So this kid right here, right? When I first met him, he told me, I done been through it all.
I know this person.
I done been through it all. I don't care what you, I'm cocky? What? Crazy, I've been through it all. And I'm like, word. So before practice was over that day, right? He was crying. I think he might have threw up that day. I think he might have threw up that day. And he beefed with me. Like, oh, he had it out for me. Like, one day I was playing, and I ain't had no equipment on, but I was hitting with him. Oh, he was trying to rock my clock. I rocked him. I set his little ass down, but he was trying to take me out. And I seen it like, he was trying to blindside me, crack back me, and everything. You know what I'm saying? But he had it out for me because he thought I was picking on him. And all I was trying to show him, like, get out your way, bro. Like, if you listen, you're going to be so war ready, it's going to be unreal. And not for football, for everything. And we're going to turn you into a machine, bro. Where it ain't nothing going to penetrate you. Like, you're going to be so bullseye on everything moving, you going to, you know what I'm saying? So this is my boy, Mr. Raekwon Harvey, a.k.a. Ray Ray, a.k.a. War Machine. My young boy, man. He got a long journey ahead of him. And It's gonna be a show to watch. Boy, I tell you. So we got this kid right here, man. We call him Mr. Angry. Mr. Angry Man. He always beefing. I don't care what time of day it is, early in the morning, late at night, mid afternoon, he always want beef. He always fight. He be ready to fight everybody all the time. All the time. Like, he be sleep. If you woke him up from sleep, like, if you even told him, like, something happened, like, yo, they got $1 million outside for you, he gonna try to fight you before he go get the $1 million. Like, I'm so serious. You know what I'm saying? And he worked his way around, man, where he had to understand from his supporting cast at home, mom dudes and pop dudes, how God really works. You know, and he landed on our doorstep, and we embraced him. And he put the work in faithfully. They tried to tell him he undersized and all this other thing, but boy, I tell you, chance he lined up on you, he'll make a 6'2" kid feel like he about 4 feet after he climb up his chest. You know what I'm saying? And he'll bowl you over a little bit. He still got some work to do. You know what I'm saying? But he real special, man. And he got a big upside and a long journey ahead of him. I want to give it up to my boy, Darren Burton.
Yeah. Yeah. A2 Arrow.
AKA Green Lantern. First name, this is first name. He inherited another name, but his first name was Mr. Savage. You know what I'm saying?
Tell me about it.
little dirty yo from the wood. You know what I'm saying? But you know my boy Hozzy B, aka Rocket the Raccoon. So, I'm thankful where out of all of this, they call me Professor X. You know? Because at OTT, that's pretty much what we're doing. It's like Professor X, the home of the gifted. Because if you look at how they treat mutants in X-Men, or any of the movies, being a black man in America, tell me how they don't treat us the same way. And that's real. You know what I'm saying? And he opens his doors to anyone and everyone that's willing to learn. There is no closed door. Everybody has a home. Each one teach one. You see Wolverine and them coming in teaching Iceman. You see Rogue and Jean Grey coming in teaching Storm. It's how it works. You know what I'm saying? They the mutants, man. We the mutants of America. So, you know, without further ado, know, thank you for KICKASSO. He, you know, made me a pair of cleats. So, y'all gonna see these on me probably about this spring with the rest of my equipment.
He lying, y'all.
With the rest of my equipment, and we gonna get it in. I wanna see who wanna tackle 220 pounds, 10 reps in a row.
You know my body.
There was another pair that was here, but due to incompetence and not understanding what it, you know, the balance of what OTT really brings. You know, it's sad. Everybody don't always stay abroad because it's a lot of work, and it's not about training in football. It's about training in life, and everybody don't get it. You know, they be stuck out in their own ways, and the biggest thing with the push that we try to get them to understand that OTT is like, get out your own way. Like, you are your biggest problem. The world ain't your problem, like, you your problem. Once you learn how to get out your way, the world can't do nothing with you but respect you. You get what I'm saying? Because you're gonna give that respect to inherit it back in return. You know, but he didn't follow the regulations and understand it properly, and hopefully, you know, God willing, he will be guided, you know, the right way. But he was here at the moment where they were getting designed. And it's my nephew, AKA Two-Face. He's not here to inherit the cleats. So hopefully, you know, the next kid will be able to wear them. Because it don't stop. It don't stop. So thank you all for coming out. It was a blessing, you know. We got a lot more, a lot other ones that
Alright, so as members of OTT, I just really want to say thank you for us. Like, half of us, you already even know us from the camp training. You just took us as your home. You're doing a lot of stuff for us. You believe in most of us. You're nobody in. Push us day in, day out to become what we all are right now. I just want to say thank you. I can't thank you enough for that. So.
They told me don't die young because I'm talented. You really fuck me, you been around and you ain't asked for shit. Voice of the streets, and if I say it, Vernie.